more than $4 for a gallon of gasoline.
It sounds ridiculous, but that's what two gas stations near Orlando International Airport are charging. The sky-high pricing next to the airport is nothing new, and it's not considered price gouging.
West 2's Todd Wilson explains the mayor of Orlando wants to make sure tourists aren't gouged at the pump on their way home from a local vacation.
No, but I guess it's because it's close to the airport. Yeah.
Francois Yeager figures that's the reason this Suncoast gas station on Semarin Boulevard near the airport charges $4.89 a gallon for regular gas. He stopped there to fill up his rental car before he returned it.
I guess I would have gone the other way if I knew it was $2 less.
There isn't a time that many can remember this Suncoast has posted a sign. It has gained a reputation of selling gas nearly double the local average. They only have their prices on the pump, which is the law. Shell is a new neighbor across the street. It is also selling without displaying its prices.
This nearly ruined.
Orlando Mayor Buddy Dyer is looking to put a cap on this situation. Mayor Dyer is asking City Council to pass an ordinance that forces gas stations in the area near the airport to post their prices on signs in front of their business. If passed, a business that doesn't comply faces a $500 a day fine till they do.
We're worried about the reputation that our city has when people are getting scammed as they're leaving from a great vacation, so we want to do what we can to protect our consumers.
Bill Wilson of Chicago says the amount he paid was ridiculous.
10 gallons, but $49.
Not posting prices is not illegal, and it isn't even price gouging. Florida has a law against price gouging during an emergency. Since the two gas stations sell high-priced gas all the time, it isn't considered price gouging. Once again, as you see, there are no signs displaying the prices of what they're charging for gas. Mayor Buddy Dyer says that he was compelled to do something because of the number of calls he was receiving day in and day out from tourists about the high prices in this area. In Orange County, Todd Wilson, West 2 News.